Chapter 429. Explaining, Li Kai calmly sat at the bow of the boat and smiled at Kerong Wang Su, who sat down beside him. In terms of beauty and allure, Kerong Wang Su was far from Chen Beijiao's level. However, Chen Beijiao didn't have the mature charm nor the dignified elegance of Kerong Wang Su. Chen Beijiao was a calamitous and kingdom-toppling beauty, a supreme enchantress that took away the souls of others with a single glance. Kerong Wang Su was also movingly beautiful, especially her mature charm no different from a ripe peach that causes hearts to beat faster. People will love her more and more the more they're exposed to her. Does Chief Kerong have something to say? Li Kai looked at her amorous features and calmly asked. Kerong Wang Su's heart was filled with emotions as she looked at this man who, despite being so much younger than her, seemed so mystical. Li Kai was very ordinary when it came to his face and aura. However, as one interacted with him more, they would find him to be full of mysteries. He would make others feel like they were being sucked in as if he was an inescapable black hole. What is young noble Li's goal for coming to Necropolis this time? Kerong Wang Su pondered for a moment before asking the question that had been haunting her. Kerong Wang Su hoped to have a real talk with Li Kai if they were to continue to stay together at Necropolis since they knew nothing about him. Li Kai didn't answer her question but asked one instead. What is Chief Kerong's goal at Necropolis? She stared at him while he met her gaze, right into her clear and bright eyes. They gazed at each other for a bit, and Kerong Wang Su was the first to turn away. She then took a deep breath and thought for a bit before resolutely saying, if we are on the same side, then we need to work together. If you wish to know, then I'll tell you. This time, I came to Necropolis to find something that my tribe had lost. Since she wanted a sincere conversation with Li Kai, she revealed the truth after contemplating for a bit. So that is the case. Li Kai smiled and replied. He understood her concerns, so he went on to say, I don't mind telling you, I came this time in order to find a certain something. What are you searching for? Kerong Wang Su inquired further. Li Kai didn't answer. He stared at her amorous snow-white face and asked, Chief Kerong, what item did your tribe lose? Kerong Wang Su became silent. This matter was of grave importance to the tribe, so she couldn't carelessly tell an outsider. Li Kai smirked at the sight of her careful contemplation. He then asked, we won't talk about this issue anymore, we can talk about the sudden eclipse instead. On that day, did you see anything strange? Li Kai found out a lot of things from Peng Xuyang, but he was now asking Kerong Wang Su to confirm it. The reason was very simple. Whenever Peng Xuyang talked about the gigantic hand from the prime ominous grave, Kerong Wang Su would yell at him to stop. This made Li Kai believe that she knew a thing or two about it. Kerong Wang Su turned around to look at the young group of six. They were sitting at the other end with their backs turned towards Li Kai and didn't seem to be paying attention to them. So young noble Li came because of this matter? Kerong Wang Su had speculated this possibility early on since Li Kai had shown interest in this matter from the very start. Li Kai did not hide anything and smiled. You can put it that way. I trust that you know a thing or two. So can you tell me? Kerong Wang Su pondered for a bit while looking at Li Kai who was calmly waiting for an answer. She then took a deep breath and nodded her head in agreement. Right afterward, she recalled the monstrous hand that Peng Xuyang talked about. It was indeed there. On the day of the eclipse, I was absorbing worldly energy while looking towards the prime ominous grave. She paused here for a moment. And then, Li Kai was not too anxious since he was quite sure about what had happened. Kerong Wang Su took a calming breath and eventually continued on. Right when the sky was no longer dark, I saw the prime ominous grave open. Peng Xuyang was not certain of this matter for he was completely horrified after seeing the gigantic hand, but Kerong Wang Su was staring at the grave the entire time. When the eclipse was over, Kerong Wang Su was astonished at the grave's opening since it seemed impossible. The grave had not been opened for a long time, and she had heard that a key was required. Her ancestor had not heard of anyone obtaining this particular key. This was the reason why she found the whole thing quite strange. This whole thing contained secrets unbeknownst to her. Each time Peng Xuyang brought it up, she quickly silenced it since she didn't want to bring about any trouble to Snow Shadow Tribe. After listening to her recollection, Li Kai smiled and said, so that was the case. Now, he was completely certain of the events that transpired. This meant that he absolutely had to obtain a key to enter the grave. Kerong Wang Su glanced in his direction and asked, since I have revealed the things young noble wanted to know, can you tell me one thing? Please go ahead. Li Kai calmly said, I'll happily reveal what I know to Chief Kerong. She then asked, how did you know the location of where the Yang Night Fish would appear? Their harvest was too shocking. There was once a descendant from an emperor's lineage who brought along a supreme treasure to Night Sea, but this person's harvest throughout an entire year was not comparable to the amount Li Kai obtained in just a month. This matter had been hanging on Kerong Wang Su's mind. Li Kai smiled and said, so Chief Kerong didn't believe me. I spoke the truth. My intuition had been very sensitive since a young age, especially when I stay in the same place for a long time. It is a natural gift from birth. Kerong Wang Su angrily glared at him since she had been tricked. She didn't believe his nonsense at all. If these fish in Nicey could be caught by intuition, then they would have become extinct already. Li Kai only smirked in response to Kerong Wang Su's red and beautiful angry glare. He couldn't tell this secret to someone else. He spent countless efforts at Necropolis. In the past millions of years, at least half of the amount of times the grave had been opened contained traces of a dark row. Li Kai. It was not easy to find the prime ominous grave's key since one needed to deal with Necropolis inhabitants. Although dealing with them was easy since one only needed sufficient Yang Night Fish to trade for the things they desired, the most essential requirement was finding the right person, no, the right ghost. Li Kai had opened the grave several times. Sometimes he was alone, sometimes he had companions, however, each time required a huge amount of Yang Night Fish, Because of these fish, Li Kai had studied Nightsea for a long time. He had even stayed at Necropolis for a generation. It could be said that currently, no one in this world understood Nightsea and Necropolis better than Li Kai, Qirong Wangsu said in exasperation. Young noble Li, even if you don't wish to speak the truth, you don't need to come up with such an excuse to fool me. As the chief, she had always been shrewd and careful, but this time, being tricked by Li Kai had done quite a number on her. Oh, it seems that I have hurt Chief Qirong's feelings. Li Kai startlingly exclaimed, if that is so, then I should try to compensate to further amend our relationship. It is my fault for not noticing your affection earlier, you. Qirong Wangsu's tender breasts swayed up and down like a powerful wave as she glared at Li Kai. She couldn't help but grip her fists. This little demon was too arrogant. He even dared to tease her. This was too much. Before, she felt that this little demon was very well behaved. But now, it was clear that it was all an act. He was just a wolf in sheep's clothing. Li Kai was carefree as always and was unafraid of her fury. He looked straight into her eyes while putting on an innocent appearance. Li Kai's pretentiously pitiful appearance made Qirong Wangsu helpless since it stopped her from acting out. While they were speaking, Peng Xuang and the other youths were whispering to each other about the two. Peng Xuang softly muttered, hey, I feel that Brother Li and our chief are quite a match, no way. The female disciple tilted her head and replied, Brother Li is about our age, but our chief is a bit older. The old saying goes, age is not a barrier. Peng Xuang mischievously went on, I feel that our chief holds Brother Li in high regard, do you guys not see it? She had been lost in thought while looking at him.